20-millimeter cannon shell exploded in his radio compartment. Shock. Internal injuries. He'll be all right, though. Flak burst scattered flying shrapnel. He's full of steel splinters. This pilot's leg is not a pretty sight. Neither are the docks at Wilhelmshaven. These men will all get the Purple Heart. And this man, too, posthumously. A transfusion right in the plane. This gunner is too weak to be moved. The new life-giving blood flowing into his veins might be the blood of a high school girl in Des Moines, a miner in Alabama, a movie star in Hollywood, or it might be your blood. Whosever it is, thanks. 36 planes left this field this morning. Now 6 more arrive. That makes 20 home. And this one's 21. More wounded aboard. Coming in with his left inboard engine dead. 23, with a feathered prop on his left outboard engine. 24, Southern Comfort, with a chunk of tail gone. 25, they flew home on their luck. 26, not a scratch. The control tower learns that 2 more landed at a British field to the south. 1 a crash landing, crew safe. That makes 28. 29, a rough landing, but her pilot's badly hurt. It's a wonder he brought her back at all. 29 planes back, so far. 29 out of 36. Our losses were heavy. But the enemies were far heavier. We destroyed a German aircraft factory, a rail junction, submarine pens, docks and harbor installations. That's specific, known damage. But who can tell the number of German torpedoes that will not be fired? The number of our convoys that will get through now? The soldiers and seamen's lives that will be saved? Or the battles that will be won instead of lost because of what these bombers and airmen did today? Pilot and tail gunner. They can laugh now. Fire on the inboard engine did this. Flames streaked back and burned the stabilizer, too. Another crew luck brought back. Here's old Bill. A pretty good airplane when it took off. Lost its nose. Lost its navigator. Bombardier wounded. Top turret gunner and pilot hit. Hydraulic system shot out. No brakes, no flaps. But old Bill came back. Now, among the returned crew members, talk flows like a river, talking out every detail of the mission. These are the faces of combat, faces of Americans who have watched their comrades die, faces that can never forget the enemy. And they're in no mood to have their picture taken. In the control tower, Colonel Ray, the group CO, is still watching and waiting. And then he spots the last flight. 3 more planes. And one of them is the ship everyone has been pulling for.
The Memphis Belle. The last few miles of this trip have been a joyride. The strain is over. They can leave their guns now. Now they know they're going to go home. to Spokane, Green Bay, Asheville, Detroit, Chicago, Fort Worth, and Yonkers. The bell comes in for her landing, but first Morgan buzzes the field, cuts the grass with a giant fortress. It's against the rules, but this is a special occasion. Memphis Belle come back to the soil of England for the 25th time. They will never forget. Another great day, soon after, Brigadier General Hansel visited the field and presented the Distinguished Flying Cross to every member of the crew. And then there was another day. Majesties, the King and Queen of England. Quinlan never thought anything like this would happen to him when he left Yonkers. The ground crew were a little self-conscious about being dressed in fatigues, but the Queen thought they were very nice. Finally, two more visitors came. General Acre, commanding the 8th Air Force, and General Devas, U.S. commander of the European theater. The Bell crew received them in flying clothes as General Acre read the order for all their 26th and most important mission: return to America to train new crews and to tell the people what we're doing here, to thank them for their help and support, and tell them to keep it up so we can keep it up, so we can bomb the enemy again and again and again until he has had enough. And then we can all come home. Thank you. were now flying deep into Germany, bringing destruction to targets almost 1,000 miles from their bases. Destruction like this. And who have never once been turned back by the enemy.